Hey guys, today we're going to go over the basics of compression. We'll take a look at some of the controls every compressor has, and then we'll go over some of the common uses for compression. So most compressors have a few basic controls you need to know about. It is common for a compressor to have a control for threshold, ratio, attack, release, and makeup gain. Some also give the option for hard or soft knee. When working with compression, the first setting you'll want to adjust is the threshold. Threshold refers to the level of sound that will activate the compressor. Any sound above the threshold will be compressed, while those that are below it will not be affected. The threshold can be adjusted so the compressor is only activated on high peaks or can be low enough that it's reached most of the time. Threshold settings typically depend on the instrument that was recorded as well as the level it was recorded at. In this case, we've added a small amount of gain reduction by adjusting the ratio. We can see as we adjust the threshold that we can have the compressor on all the time or just when the loud peaks are in the track. After the threshold has been set, you'll want to adjust the ratio. This determines how much gain reduction is applied when the signal goes above the threshold. For example, if a ratio is set to 3 to 1 and the signal is 3 dB above the threshold, the output will only be 1 dB above the threshold. Limiters have an infinite ratio, meaning any signal that is above the threshold will be brought down to the level of the threshold. So we can adjust the ratio at this point. When we go from 2 to 1 to 8 to 1, you should notice an increase in gain reduction. Peaks of the sound are now closer to the level of the threshold. Not only can you control the amount of compression using threshold and ratio, but you can also control how fast the compressor turns on and off. Attack refers to how fast the compressor is activated after the threshold is reached. Release refers to how long it takes for the compressor to deactivate after the signal goes below the threshold. By adjusting the attack and release, we can affect the punch of the track. By setting the attack so the compressor is activated just after the initial peak and the release so that the compressor deactivates before the next note, we can have very prominent peaks at the beginning of each note. This allows the track to punch through the mix easier. Typically, when working with compression, longer attacks and release times tend to sound more natural. After compression is applied to the track, it typically results in a reduction of volume. To counteract this effect, we can use makeup gain to increase the level of the track. When adding makeup gain, I like to switch the compressor on and off using the bypass button. Then I use this to set the level to about the same as it was before. By setting the level to the same as before, we can easily compare the difference the compressor has made on and off without the issue of volume change. Some compressors also have the option to select either hard or soft knee. This controls whether the ratio is gradual or full around the threshold. When using a soft knee, the ratio is gradually applied. This means that the levels just over the threshold will not have the full ratio. On the other hand, hard knee will have the full ratio as soon as the level goes above the threshold. Typically, a hard knee is used for instruments like drums and bass, while soft knee is used on vocals and guitar. Now that the compressor is completely set up, we'll press the bypass and compare our results to the original track. As you can tell, we've smoothed out the peaks of the bass and now have a consistent level that will fit better in our mix. Thanks for watching this video on dynamic range compression. Click the link on screen or in the video description to learn about 8 audio effects you should know for recording, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more videos.